All right, welcome everyone. A few years ago, well, let's be honest, it's been more than a few years, I was entering a room just like this one. I remember feeling excited and nervous at the same time. It was my first day of law school in Leiden University. And I remember I felt a bit overwhelmed by this big classroom. Of course, it did not help that on my way to class, I got lost by bike on the canals of Leiden. And I remember entering this room, and this room was so full that I had to sit on the stairs. That was meant for the latecomers like me. So, today you are here because you're considering your own first step into university life. And we are here to help you by providing the right information. Welcome everybody here who came to Rotterdam, and welcome everybody who is watching from home in the live stream. My name is Esther de Koning, and I work at the admissions office in Rotterdam School of Management, Erasmus University. So, this presentation will last for around 20 minutes. After the presentation, there will be time to ask questions. So, what are we going to talk about? The topics of today is first the selection. The selection of IBA. So it's a numerus fixus program, and we were going to talk about what the steps are. I will tell you more about admission requirements, including a self-check to check whether you meet the general admission requirements. And afterwards, we will talk about the selection process and how we as Rotterdam School of Management make the ranking. And finally, I'll give you more information about application, including some tips. So, what is a numerus fixus? Most of the programs in the Netherlands have an open admission, meaning if you have the right level of diploma, you can be admitted. IBA is classified as a numerus fixus program, so this is one of the selection methods that we can use in the Netherlands. It basically means that we are bound by the rules of the government. For example, that you can apply for a maximum 2 numerus fixus studies in the Netherlands. You can apply for more programs, but only 2 of them can be a numerus fixus programs. Furthermore, we have a fixed number of offers that we can send. So, if we allow every eligible candidate to start a program, that is simply not possible because there's simply too many applications that we receive. So the maximum number is set at 750. A second thing is the deadlines. So all numerus fixus programs in the Netherlands have a fixed deadline. So this is very important for you to remember. Because if you miss the deadline, you cannot start next September. So, the first deadline is the 15th of January. StudyLink closes at midnight. And we have experienced that before. This is midnight in local Rotterdam time, so not elsewhere in the world, so keep in mind. The 15th of January, you will have to apply in StudyLink, the national registration database. So after registration in StudyLink, you will receive a link to our online portal of Rotterdam School of Management, which is called OLAF. And there you will be able to fill in all the necessary information, all the documents to upload that are required for your application, and submit your application. So those two deadlines, keep in mind. You can already apply now because StudyLink opened for registration by the 1st of October, but don't take your phone now and apply now, but wait for after this presentation. And then the 15th of January, you have to submit your application in StudyLink. Afterwards, there are still a few more weeks to upload any additional documents and submit your application. On the 15th of April, the results are announced. So this is for every numerous fixes program in the Netherlands. So you will know your ranking number, and you will know on the 15th of April whether you are immediately admitted to the program or whether you're on the waiting list. So, next question. What are the admission requirements? So, the first admission requirement is the diploma. You need to have a diploma which makes you eligible for the program. So, in the Netherlands, this is the Dutch pre-university diploma. We have listed on our website for around 60 different international diplomas. So please have a look on our website whether you meet the requirements. Some examples are the international BAC, the European BAC, the French BAC General, and the German Zeugnis der Allgemeine Hochschulreife. So please have a look on our website to if you are in doubt whether you meet the diploma requirements. To see whether you meet those. Secondly, mathematics. So, a solid background in mathematics is very important. This is because it is necessary to finish the program successfully. So, we are selecting based on mathematics. So, for the pre-university diploma, from the Netherlands, you need to have at least Wiskunde A with grade 7 or Wiskunde B with grade 6. On our website, again, you will find the mathematic requirements per diploma for all the international diplomas as well. If you don't meet this requirement, it is possible to compensate for this by passing one of the mathematic tests. So there are several ways. There are the Boswell tests and the CCVX test, for example. However, we recommend you to have a look at the OMPT test, which is a proctored test online. So you can just make it at home. That is very easy. And if you pass this test, then you do meet as well the mathematic requirements. So, thirdly, English. So, as the IBA program is an English taught program, we have a look at your English proficiency. The Dutch pre-university applicants, they need to have at least a grade seven for the subject English. And for all the other diplomas, please have a look. So some of the diplomas, they will necessarily need to take an English test. Others, they do meet the requirements if you have a certain level and a certain grade for the subject English. So this depends per diploma. If you don't have the required grade or subject, you can pass one of the tests that we accept at Rotterdam School of Management, which is TOEFL, IELTS, or Cambridge. So please make sure to register for one of those tests on time in the test centers, as they might fill up quickly. You will have time until the 15th of March to meet the requirements. So for both mathematics and English, you will have time until the 15th of March to hand in a sufficient test result. So, if you don't meet the requirement now, you can still apply and register for one of the tests later. All right. On our website, you can check yourself whether you meet our general admission requirements. So, you can fill in your diploma. You will see as well the grade that you are required. That because we are requiring per diploma a certain minimum grade to be selected, and whether you meet mathematics or English. So, just for you, for your information, if you meet the mathematics or English requirement and the diploma requirements, this does not mean that you will be selected. So it's not a guarantee that you will receive an offer. Because we rank all our students, it depends on, and I will talk about that a bit later, whether you will meet an, whether you will still receive an offer, that depends on two different factors. So, and in general, we can already tell you, if you don't meet the minimum requirement that we ask for per diploma, so for the Dutch pre-university diploma, this is a 7, the chances of selection are very small. So we would recommend you to, for example, go for a different program. If you're proficient in Dutch, that could be bedrijfskunde, or to go for an IBA program elsewhere. In the past years, nobody has been selected when you don't meet the average grade requirement. So this is how our website looks like. You can fill in the diploma. And then you can check what the requirements are in terms of diploma, mathematics, English, and average grade. So, next question. Which grades do I need to submit? So most of the applicants that apply for the IBA program are currently in their final year. So that means that they're not graduated yet. So for those applicants, we ask you to fill in our online application form and upload the transcript of your penultimate year, which is the year before your final year. So for the Dutch pre-university applicants, that is 5 VWO. The reason for this is that we assess applicants based on an entire completed year. So as we work with deadlines for the numerus fixus, by the 31st of January, applicants who are still in their final year, they haven't graduated yet, so we cannot assess them on a full completed year. So we will look at the grades from your previous year. What else do you need? Next to the transcript, you need to fill in a diploma statement. A diploma statement is a statement. You can find the templates on our website, which mentioned the subjects you're taking in your final year and the subjects you're taking actually an exam in. So that can differ per diploma. You have to print it out, and your school teacher or school counselor can stamp this and put a signature. So we need to know what kind of subjects you will have in your final year. For specifically for IB students and A-level students from the UK or international A-levels, we do not accept predicted grades or accept, we might accept them, but we don't consider them. So only achieved grades, so from the previous year. We don't accept mock exams either, so just for you to be aware. So this is valid for the applicants in their final year, and then we have applicants who have already graduated. So for those applicants, we'll ask you to upload your secondary school diploma. We'll have a look at your final year of school grades and the national exams, or the school exams. This depends a little bit per diploma. So have a look at our website, exactly for your diploma, what is valid. Like most of the countries, they have national exam. In some countries like Belgium, they do it a little bit different again. They don't have state exams, national exams. So for them, it's not possible to assess them based on those grades. So yes, this is all the information for the grades. And then we go to selection points and criteria. So, how do we select? So, Rotterdam School of Management selects all based on 2 criteria. So, the first one is, as we talked about, average grade. Average grade counts for 75% of the total ranking number, which is therefore very important. So, on our website, you can find all the average grades per diploma, what we require. So you have to have this minimum in order to apply. Otherwise, you will most likely not be selected. So that is the case in the past years. You received over 2,000 applications and only 650 students can start. 750 offers are sent, but only we know that not all of those will actually make it. So, meaning that you need to have the minimum grade. So, we make this selection based, the ranking we make is based mostly on those grades. So, if you have, for example, a 7 for the Dutch VWO diploma, you get 1 point, 1 selection point. The higher your grade is, the more selection points you will have, and the higher the chance that you will receive an offer. So, and if your average grade is lower than the minimum, you won't get any points at all. The second selection criteria is motivation. Motivation counts for 25% of your ranking number. We have 3 motivation questions, so you don't have to write a motivation letter, but answer 3 motivation questions, and those are filled in our online applications form in OLAF. So on our website you will find as well in the frequently asked question what the questions are exactly. I'll wait for a few seconds because there's a lot of information on this sheet, I know. So, in order to make sure that all applicants who meet the general requirements that we're asking for, so both in terms of level of diploma, mathematics, English, and average grade, that those ones are on top of the ranking, we're asking you, are in the first tier, we have created like this different tiers. So, in the past years, only the applicants who met all the requirements were put in the first tier and received an offer. Meaning if you're not in the first tier, that you will automatically receive an offer, that doesn't mean that. So, in general, we have in the past years, we received more or less, we received over 2,000 applicants in total. And the first tier was in average around 1,400. So 1,400 of those 2,000 applicants were in the first tier. So, and there we will send the offers. If you're looking at this schedule now and you see, okay, well, I do meet general diploma requirements. I do meet English, but I don't meet like the grade for mathematics because I scored lower. You can make the mathematics test and therefore change from the third tier into the first tier. That is a possibility. If your average grade is insufficient, so you're in the second tier, it is not possible to move to the first tier because you cannot compensate for the average grade that you have. Okay, so a question for you. What is the registration deadline in StudyLink? January? Good. I'm happy to hear that you paid a bit of attention in the past minutes. All right, okay, then we're going to talk about the application. So, all the application step. Now you have hopefully met all the admission requirements, it's time to apply. So, first step, StudyLink. From now onwards until the 15th of January, you can apply in StudyLink, the national registration system. So you can submit your application for IBA. The second step is to fill in OLAF, the online application form, and submit your application. So after the deadline, there's still 2 more weeks. The deadline is the 31st of January. And again, local time in Rotterdam. We will send you all the information via Olaf. So if you applied, you will receive a message via Olaf. If you're missing documents, and we will ask you to upload a different document. We will send those messages via Olaf. So please make sure to check Olaf regularly. You will receive a notification in your personal inbox as well that you have a message in Olaf, but please make sure to check your messages in a regular basis. If you still need to pass mathematics or English, you will have, after the deadline has passed, still time to submit your application, to submit your mathematics or English test results. On the 15th of April, all the results are published. So that's for all the numerus fixus programs in the Netherlands. And the first offers are sent, therefore. So we will send 750 offers. All those applicants have 2 weeks to either accept or decline their offer in StudyLink. If you don't accept or decline, then it will be automatically sent to the next person on the waiting list. So your offer will be automatically declined. So please be aware, you have only 2 weeks. If you have, for example, doubts whether you want to accept or decline because you're waiting for a different offer from a different university, then please accept, because it's not possible anymore to accept afterwards. You can always decide later onwards to decline. Just to keep in mind, there are many people on the waiting list, so don't wait until the last minute. But well, that is our tip. So, the waiting list stops at the 1st of August. So no more offers are sent out by August. And from then on, there will be only less. If someone declines, there will be not be sent a new offer anymore. So you will still have time then until the beginning of August. And a few diplomas are accepted because they will receive their results only later. To send your diploma, so we know that you met the requirements, and that will make your offer unconditional, your conditional offer unconditional. All right, and some last tips for your application. So the first one, apply as early as possible. And again, not now, but maybe later today, if you have all the documents ready. This in general makes it easier for us. In case you will still need to upload a different document because the document is faulty or we cannot open it, or you, for example, accidentally sent grades from your last year instead of your penultimate year, then we will still have time to check those and send you a notification, so you will still have time to upload it. So apply as early as possible. Second one, read the website. So we've noticed that there's always a lot of questions for applicants, but we have created this very nice frequently asked questions section, and most of the information is there. So the questions that we receive in our inbox, in general, we can tell you already, like, have a look at our website, and this information is there. So via our website, you will find a contact form. So if it happens that you have a question and you think, okay, I have exceptional circumstances, and this information is really not to be found on our website, you can contact us via the contact form. The third tip, never cancel your registration in StudyLink unless you are 100% sure. Every year it happens to us that we receive questions from students who accidentally deleted their application in StudyLink because they wanted to delete it for a different program. And that is very sad, but that is something that we cannot stop. And once you're out, you're out. So be careful with that. And the last one is be patient. So, as I said before, on the 15th of April, you will receive your ranking number. If your ranking number is, for example, 1,000, the chances of selections are still there. So in the past years, on the 15th of April, the first 750 will receive a ranking number, and it will go down as with time, because there are many students that receive, for example, a different offer from a different university, or they decide to take a gap year. Of those 750, more or less 650 end in the program. So there are quite some cancellations, and that is positive for the students who are lower on the ranking list. In the past 3 years, the average number of 1,250 applicants received an offer. We have created a website as well. On our website, you will find the ranking number. So if you're still wondering whether you might receive an offer or whether you should go to a different university, you can check our website as well to see which ranking number are called. And lastly, some practical matters. So, the tuition fee for most of the students who are applicants from the Netherlands, that is probably not a surprise, but students who have the nationality from the European Economic Area, including Switzerland, are paying this year 2,601 euro per year. So count 3 times for that, because the program is lasting for 3 years. Students who pay the institutional fee pay 12,700 per year. Living costs. That it depends, of course, a bit per lifestyle. So you can find on our website the average price of books, housing, groceries, going out, bike repair costs, etc. So that really depends a little bit on your lifestyle, what that will be. Scholarships. So Rotterdam School of Management offers a limited number of scholarships. And this is mostly for students who pay the institutional fee. So who pay the full fee because they have a nationality from outside the European Economic Area. These are mostly waivers. So that means that the scholarship, the tuition fee is waived up to the 2,600. So you still have to have sufficient financial resources to pay for housing, for example, but your tuition fee will be lower. For students who are from the European Economic Area, we have a very nice scholarship called the Entrepreneurial Spirit Scholarship. This is funded by a few alumni from Rotterdam School of Management. They are providing mentorships for the entire 3 years by students who were working now in mostly big companies, or they set up their own company, and they pay as well for the tuition fee, including some money for books. Visa and residence permit. So some of the applicants, they do need a visa and residence permit requested by the Dutch IND. This is arranged by our university, by the Erasmus University. So you just have to fill in all the information which is required, and they are providing with the entire application. And then last, housing. It's a bit difficult to find housing in the entire Netherlands, but in Rotterdam as well. We do offer housing mostly for international students. So there is a possibility. However, we cannot guarantee housing for all the students. So more information about all these subjects can be found on our website. So it's just a short introduction. And that was it. Thank you for your attention. And then it's time to ask some questions. In general, I would recommend you to give a bit of, to ask general questions, like, for example, specific, for example, if you're from Lithuania and you have mathematics B with a grade 7, is this sufficient? That is not information that is applicable for everybody, so you can always visit us at the stand if you have a specific question. But yeah, let's start. I don't see any.
Yes, hello.
Joanna, yeah. Can you?
I have a question.
Yes.
I just have a question because I'm not sure to have understood the grades that we need to provide you with. Because...
Could you speak up a little bit?
Yes, you said that you do not accept the predicted grades. But for kids which are in international baccalaureate, the grade at the end of the grade 11 will be predicted grades. So I do not really understand what we need to provide you with.
So is the question about the international BAC?
Yes, exactly.
Is that correct? Whether
yes.
You need... Yeah, so the admission requirements for the minimum grade for the IB is 33 points. So we'll look at your penultimate year, so the first diploma year, and you need to have at least 33 points, and that is counted from the six core subjects, so excluding the extra points.
Okay.
And if you meet that requirement, 33, then you will have one selection point.
Okay.
The higher, the more selection points you will have.
Okay, but...
But if you don't meet that the chances of selection is very low.
Okay, but you said that you will not accept predicted grades.
No, we don't predict it, so we look at the grades from the end of diploma year one. Not diploma year two, because then you will have your diploma, your IB diploma, if you're in your penultimate year.
Okay.
In case you have already graduated for your IB diploma, then we will look at the IB diploma, and there it will be mentioned on the diploma how many points you will have.
Okay, thank you.
All right.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Hoi, ja, ik vroeg me af of alle vakken meetellen bij dus dat gemiddelde van je cijfer wat je moet hebben. Want ik heb bijvoorbeeld Latijn, maar ik weet niet of je dat dan weg kan strepen daarbij. Of dat ook meetelt met dat 7.0 gemiddelde.
Ja, yeah, so all the courses are being counted, are included.
Oké, okay, dankjewel.
Ja.
Hallo. So assuming that requirements are met, so you're in tier one, if your exam results for the second year are lower than the first year, does your ranking drop lower and so you have a lesser chance of getting into the program?
Could you repeat your question?
So assuming that you get in with the results of your first year exams.
And we're talking about the IB diploma?
IB diploma or in general, I think
mm-hmm.
You said. If your results for the second year exams are lower, do you have a lesser chance?
No.
Do you drop in the ranking?
No. So for all the applicants who haven't graduated yet, so who are now in their final year, we have a look at their penultimate year, so the year before. So if, for example, for the IB diploma, you have 35 points, and in your final, you will be assessed based on those 35 points. In case you're in your final year and you're average grade drops to 33, for example, we don't withdraw your application because you have already showed that your average grade was sufficient. We receive this question a lot, so it's a good question because students as well are very worried that, for example, during exam times, we receive a lot of phone calls and emails from students like, I think I didn't perform as good as I was hoping for. No, we don't withdraw your application. However, you still need to obtain your diploma, of course, because that is necessary. If you don't have a diploma, then we're not able to grant you admission to the bachelor program. But if you score a little bit less than expected, that is okay, because we of course understand that during exam and in your final year that there are some nerves going on.
And does the grade of 33 still have to be met in the case of the IB diploma?
Sorry, I didn't...
The grade of 33, which is the requirement for this course, I believe.
Yeah, so the 33 is required?
Still has to be met in this case, right?
No. So that's the thing. Of course, we expect you to maintain the same level and at least to meet the minimum. But if you're scoring a little bit less and if you're scoring, for example, 32 or 31, in reality, it's fine. Of course, we always check your diploma and your final grades. However, as said, we are... kind people, and that's okay.
For the 33 points, if I'm planning to apply in December and I get my report card from the first semester of the second IB, is that possible to apply with?
No, we only look at achieved grades from the previous year. So for all applicants, this is the same. We don't look at the current year anymore because it's a basic question, so all numerous fixes programs in the Netherlands do the same. However, it's as well a practical question. If we have to wait for all those grades to assess by January, we are not allowed in our office. It's impossible for us to still do the ranking by then because we have to assess all applicants from then until March because we have to hand in the results of March. So. Now, if you're not graduated yet, we only look at the grades from the penultimate year, so the last year's grades.
But I'm still able to, because the deadline is 15th of January,
yes,
and I apply December, because you said that you won't have time to...
No, it's just all applicants are assessed the same way. So if you have graduated, yes, you can use your IB diploma. If you have not, we will use the grades from the penultimate year.
Okay, thank you.
And it doesn't matter whether you will have the... grades from your current year in January or even in November, that will be the same.
I have a quick question on the balance of nationality. So in your when you submit the 750 submissions, let's say, do you balance that globally, let's say 60% European, and even within Europe, Italian, Spanish, Germans, French, etc. Is there anything of this in your criteria
It's simply not possible to select in that sense, to say, okay, we're lacking a few students from Greece, let's give a few preference to students from Greece. No, it doesn't work like that. So we really look at the applicants and in the end who meets the requirements. In general, in the past years, we've seen more or less the same balance between Dutch and international students. It's a very international group. And over half so far has been already Dutch students. Dutch students, students with a secondary school education from the Netherlands.
Is het ook mogelijk om zeg maar meer een vraag te stellen over specifiek van over de opleiding? Is het meer vooral over de application?
So this session is only about admission, toelating. Yes.
Okay, dan. Kijken ze eigenlijk alleen maar naar de examencijfers of is het ook nog meer door het jaar heen, waar bijvoorbeeld het vijfde jaar of het vierde jaar, dat ze nog kijken naar de cijfers?
Nou, so for the Dutch students, you have to fill in a specific diploma statement, which is called the 5 VWO diploma statement. You can find it on the website. There you find the specific information. So we don't look at grades from 3 VWO, for example. So please have a look at our website and you can exactly see the diploma statement for the Dutch pre-university diploma.
Okay,
all right. I think this was it for today. If you still have questions about admissions, you can visit us at the stand downstairs.